Almost all large businesses, and also many smaller ones, are set up as corporations. For example, companies that we commonly refer to as Microsoft, Apple, Nike, McDonald's, and Toyota are actually corporations. Publicly held corporations are those owned by the public. Their stocks are traded daily in markets called stock markets. A corporation is set up with money or capital raised through the sale of shares of stock. A share of stock represents partial ownership in a corporation. The shares of publicly held corporations are typically owned by many different individuals and institutions. Share prices of these firms are determined by supply and demand in public markets called stock exchange. The New York Stock Exchange is the largest of several exchanges in the United States. Daily stock prices are readily found in many places on the internet, such as finance.yahoo.com, wallstreetjournal.com, and information on the stock of many widely held companies such as Apple or Nike is also found in weekly financial magazines. And let's take a look at the different components of a stock table. The first thing that we have highlighted here is the stock that we're referring to. This is the ticker symbol under which the stock trades on the market. And in this slide, we're looking at Best Buy that has the symbol BBY. The next thing we have highlighted is the closing price at the end of the day for a share of stock in Best Buy. The net change is telling us the increase, and this is an increase, otherwise there'd be a minus sign there, in the value of the share for the day compared to the previous day. So it went up by $1.63 over the closing price the previous day's stock market. This highlighted area is showing us the overall highest and lowest price the stock sold during the year. So we're seeing a high of $62.70 per share and a low of $22.48 per share. The closing price was $52, so it's off by about $10 approximately from the highest that it's been so far this year. This highlighted region of the stock table shows our year-to-date increase in the price of stock. So we are looking at a 116% change, and in this case increase, over the lowest that it's been in the past year. This highlighted section is showing us the dividend that is being paid for this company. All corporations are required to have an annual meeting. The stockholders have rights to be at the meeting. They have a board of directors that is elected by stockholders, and the board of directors hires the executive officers. The board of directors also distribute a portion of any profits in the form of dividends, which are regular payments to the stockholders. And this is showing us that this stock is paying a 40 cent dividend quarterly per share of ownership. That means if we multiply it by 4, for every share of stock that's owned, the owner would receive $1.60 in profits or dividends. This would be reportable income for tax purposes. The next section is showing us the yield, and this is the percentage of annual yield based on the current price. So it's 0.8%, and again based on the closing price here of $52.19. PE is short for price to earnings ratio. We have the definition here, a comparison of the closing price of the stocks to the company's earnings. We'll take a closer look at this later in the section. The stock table generally will show also the volume In other words, the number of shares that are traded during the day, depending on the company, this could be hundreds as here, but it could be thousands or even a higher multiple. So during the day, there were over 4, almost 5 million shares trading during the course of the stock market's activity. Here they're asking us to determine what the cost would be for buying 50 shares of Alcoa and 40 shares of Benetton. The stock table is going to show us what that closing price is so we can determine what the cost per share is. So we will take the number of shares being purchased times the price per share at the closing. Multiplying those gives us the cost. 40 shares of Benetton closing at 23.10 according to this stock table, multiplying and then adding those two together. So this would be the amount of money needed to purchase these stocks as indicated. If you're interested in buying stocks, individuals just can't call up the New York Stock Exchange. We need to go through a stock broker. If you go to a regular stock broker, they will charge more than some other options we'll discuss in just a second, but they do offer financial advice, whether this is a risky or a pretty safe investment. Some people will trade stocks using discount brokers who charge less, but they aren't giving you the financial advice. And we also have the option of trading stocks just over the internet by going through some stock or financial companies such as E-Trade, Schwab, Fidelity, and so on, where the cost is extremely low. But again, there's not always that advice that the research of whether this is a good investment or not is on the shoulders of the individual investor. Next, we're going to find what the dividends are for these two stocks that we paid or that we purchased. So we had 50 shares of Alcoa purchased recently, and if we look at the information on the dividend here, it's showing that Alcoa is paying a 60-cent dividend. That would be quarterly, so we'll multiply that by 4. That is the dividend paid per share, and because of the purchase of or ownership of 50 shares, we'll take 50 times that $2.40 for a dividend or share in the profits of this company of $120. Benetton is paying 81 cents per share quarterly on paying out for dividends, taking 81 cents times 4 and multiplying that by the number of shares owned. That's the dividend payment received from that company. So here is the dividends received for the ownership of these two companies. And again, as I mentioned, this is income and needs to be reported on taxes.